Okay, bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Good evening, everyone. Hello, how are you?
Hello, I'm fine, and you?
I'm fine too. Thank you, Ursula. Hey, Dona. Hey, Hidayat. Okay, so actually you know the schedule in our class is Monday to Wednesday is Miss Farah's session, and she's gonna teach the main lesson actually. So, but I'm gonna refresh all the lesson that has been taught from Monday to Wednesday. Okay, are you ready?
Yes.
I'm gonna share you. It's gonna be a bit different. I have another presentation that's a bit different with Miss Rara previous teaching, but this is also about telephony. Actually, we have what we call the certification. In BNSP. BNSP certification, we have what we call the English for Administrative Office, right? And so one of the main purpose of having this certification is so that people can have like a certain standard about the common English phrases used in the office, like for answering telephone, which I kind of summon in this presentation called telephony. So using general expression in telephony is the main scheme. Okay, the main scheme is making telephone calls, taking and giving messages by telephone, and giving messages by telephone. This is what we're going to learn on this session. Okay, so about using general expression in telephony, making telephone calls, taking and giving messages by telephone, giving messages by telephone. This is what we're going to learn here. Okay. And now, first, let me ask you about this. Have you ever made a telephone call? Uswa, have you ever made a telephone call? Hidayat? Donna, have you ever made a telephone call?
Yes, I have.
Ah, you have. How do you make the call? Using a telephone set at home or a mobile phone?
In office.
Ah, in the office. Okay, so using a telephone set.
Yes.
Ah, okay. Who do you frequently call?
My client.
Oh, your client. When do you usually need to make a call? On what situation? On what condition?
Making agenda agenda with client.
Oh, I see. Okay. Who has ever made a telephone call in English? Have you ever made the call in English?
Who has ever?
Have you
to
ever made?
Yes, I have.
Really? Is one of your client is a foreigner?
No. Yes.
Ah, yes. Oh, I see. Good one. How about you, Uswa? Thank you, Donna. Uswa, how about you, Uswa? How about you, Miss Uswa? Have you ever made a telephone call?
Yes.
Yes. How do you make the call? Using a telephone set at home or a mobile phone?
With mobile phone.
Ah, mobile phone. Who do you frequently call?
Dua kali, twice ya.
Who do you frequently call?
My husband.
Ah, your husband. When do you usually need to make the call? On what situation do you call him?
Nanyain kabar, nanyain
Oh
pulang.
my God, so
Apa
sweet.
gue?
Just some greeting. You can answer like that. You can answer it like that. Just some greetings and some small talk. Yeah.
Begitu ya.
Itu nanyain kabar itu masuk ke greeting. Jadi itu bilangnya just some
Oh.
greetings or small talk. Kayak ngobrol-ngobrol. Ngobrol-ngobrol itu bahasa Inggrisnya small talk.
Oh, jadi just greeting, small talk itu, my
Just
answer
some greetings
gitu.
and small talk kayak gitu. Oh, good job. Okay, who has have you ever made the call in English? Have you ever made a telephone
No.
call in English, Usma?
No.
No. Ah, now we're gonna start. We're gonna
Oh,
try.
okay.
Yeah. So this is
Maybe
several.
next.
Can I, what is it saying? Kenapa, Bu?
Enggak, sama. Enggak, sama. Kalau mungkin nanti
Yeah. With
telepon
me, of
Inggris.
course. Of course you have the phone call in English with me. Yes, because we need to practice our English, right? Okay, good job. Okay. So now in telephone call we have several phrasal verbs. Phrasal verbs ini adalah kata yang dia dua kata yang berdiri sendiri kayak cut sama off ya kan. Dia punya arti masing-masing. Tapi kalau digabung jadi menjadi satu arti yang berbeda. Itu yang disebut phrasal verbs. Jadi phrasal verbs ini adalah istilah untuk dua kata yang ketika digabung dia menjadi satu kata yang maksudnya arti yang lain yang berbeda dari dua kata dasarnya dia kayak gitu. Nah, di setiap masing-masing bidang ada phrasal verb-nya masing-masing. Kayak kedokteran ya ada phrasal verb-nya masing-masing, mengajar ada phrasal verb-nya masing-masing. Nah, kalau dalam bertelepon ini adalah phrasal verbs-nya ya. So this is the phrasal verbs for telephoning, okay? We have what we call cut off. So cut off is when you end a telephone conversation because of technical problems. This is what we call it, cut off, okay? And then we have get through. Get through is when you want to reach someone. Okay, Uswa, Donna, try to think of how you're going to make a sentence using this phrasal verbs. Okay, so I'm gonna explain it first about these phrasal verbs, and then I'm gonna ask you to make a sentence using these phrasal verbs, okay? So cut off, like for example, because the line was not good, so I have to cut off my phone call with Uswa, something like that, okay? And then get through. I don't know what is wrong with Donna's phone call because I tried to get through her but I couldn't. The line is keep busy. The line is still busy like that. Yeah. So get through is trying to reach someone, like trying to call someone, get through. Cut off is when your telephone call ends because of technical problems. Hang on. Hang on is like wait for a short while. Okay. When you're calling to someone and saying like, okay, hang on, Uswa. I need to go to the toilet first. Okay, but you still want to talk to Uswa, right? So you said, okay, hang on, Uswa. I'll be right with you, like that, something like that. Or you need to eat something, or you need to cook something, like that. Hang on. Pick up is like when you answer the phone. Donna, please pick up the phone. Something like that. Okay. And then speak up and speak louder. Yeah, you need to speak up. I cannot hear you. You make a sentence like that. Get back. Okay. I need to ask someone about the information. I'll get back to you, okay? Yeah, that's how you make a sentence. Put through. Put through is when you connect to another person. Okay. Hello, may I speak to Miss Donna? Okay, I will have Donna. I'm gonna put you through Donna, like that. I'm gonna put through the call. Okay, Donna, here's a call for you. I'm gonna put through the call. Yeah, that's how you make it a sentence, okay? And then hold on, wait for a moment. Hold on is wait for a moment. It's a bit different with hang on, okay? Hold on, it's the same. Wait, hang on, hold on. But hang on is more short than hold on. Hold on is longer. Okay, could you hold on for a while? I have a stomach ache. I need to go to the toilet first. Yeah, hold on is longer than hang on. Break up. Break up is to become inaudible. It's like when you call someone, but your voice become breaking up. Donna, hello? I cannot hear you. Your voice is breaking up. Yeah, because the voice is unclear, something like that. Okay, and hang up. Be careful. Do not switch this with hang on. Hang on is waiting. Hang up is ending the call. Yeah, I need to hang up now. I have to go. Yeah, something like that. Okay, Uswa, Donna. Now, pick your phrasal verb and try to make a sentence using it. Uswa, what's your choice?
Apa ya? Bikin kalimat. Ya, bingung. Udah di jarum muda.
Try it. You can do it, Uswa. Let's go. Try, try. Do you want me to pick
Okay.
it up for you?
Hang up.
Huh, this is easy. I need to hang up now, something like that. But you
Bikin
need to
sentence with Indonesia.
yeah.
Bikin Indonesia dulu ya.
Oh.
Bikin
Donna,
kalimat.
what's your choice? Eh, kalian tuh bisa ini juga gak sih? Ada tulisan gitu. Kalian bisa nulis-nulis juga gak sih? Can you do the writing thing too?
I read in the book.
Ah, I see. Okay. I thought you're going to write. I think you can write in here because on the kids class, I noticed that one of the kids, Vita, she was writing on the screen. Oh, inshallah. Okay. Don, what's your phrasal verbs?
Sorry deh, nggak fokus lagi sambil nyuapin.
Masya Allah. Donat, you have to make a sentence using this phrasal verb. But pick one, just one. You don't have to like pick all. Only one.
Hold on.
Yes. What's the sentence? Go ahead.
Wait a moment, please. Wait for a moment, please.
Yeah, you have to change it into hold on, of course. Hold on there. I need to apa gitu. Hold on for a second. Could you hold on, please? I need to apa gitu.
Could you hold on, please? I need to check. See in the best or not.
Ah, good job, Don. So cool, Donna. Good job. Oh, thank you, Don. Good job. That's true. Could you please hold on? I need to check the key whether it's in the desk or not. Yeah. Good job. Kamu memang hebat.
Iya, Donna keren.
Oh.
Aku masih mikir.
All you need to know is the basic sentence like Okay, for example, I need to hang up because of what, ya? Tinggal tambahin apa penyebabnya gitu. I need to hang up the call because I need to cook dinner for my husband, something like that.
Lagi bikin itu soalnya I must hang up. Udah atur nih. Lagi bikin hang up ya gak.
Kalau enggak, you can say don't hang up yet. I still need to talk to your father, something like that. Yeah. Ayo, semangat. Ayo, what's your sentence? Go ahead. Usah.
Wait.
Hold on dong, hold on dong. Okay.
Ini I call you lama sudahlah dari tadi gitu. Cepat pick up your phone. Saya sudah menelponmu dari tadi gitu.
Pick up your call. I've been calling you. Itu berarti pakai
Please
pick
pick
up.
up your phone. You call ya?
Ya, yeah, pick up your call.
No.
Pick up your phone juga bisa. Pick up your phone. I've been calling
Pick up
you.
your
Hey,
phone.
where are you? Pick up your call. Pick up the phone. Kayak gitu.
Saya sudah menelpon kamu dari tadi gitu.
Yes, I've been
Bahasa
calling you
Inggrisnya?
since yesterday. Ya, itu apa? Majas hiperbola gitu loh. I've been calling you since yesterday, ya. Saya udah nelpon dari kemarin, oh, padahal mah ibaratnya baru beberapa kali telepon kayak gitu. Tapi we can say that in a informal way.
Boleh.
Boleh. Kan lebay ya, lebay gitu ceritanya kalau sama temen kan suka melebih-lebihkan bercanda gitu kan.
Yeah.
Okay, go ahead. Say your sentence. Sebutkan kalimatnya.
Ulang, repeat again.
Nah.
Please pick up your phone. I've been calling you since yesterday gitu.
Yes, that's right.
Lebih gak sih?
Yes, that's right. You have to have the confidence, Oswa. It's okay to make mistakes.
Yes.
Good job. Thank you, Oswa. Thank you, Donna. You guys are the best. Yeah. So amazing. Okay. So this is like the phone. There's also like the formal way and the informal way. Everything in language is always like that, even in Bahasa, right? So there's always the formal way and the informal way. Like for example, when you greet someone in the formal way, you say good morning, or when you answer a call, this is Dewi speaking. Ini this is, you know, the first I think in telephone phrasal verbs, the first thing that my boss teach me when I work in the bank. When I work in the bank, this my favorite boss, Miss Peppy. She's like, when I answer the call, "Halo, dengan Dewi," and she said, "Oh my God, Dewi ya, it's very itu kuno banget, jelek banget sih cara ngangkat telepon kayak begitu gitu ya. This is Dewi speaking kayak gitu dong kalau ngangkat telepon. Ya, ini adalah jadi saya selalu ingat ini ya. This is Dewi speaking ya, because my boss first taught me about this. This is Dewi speaking like that. Okay. Could I speak to Uswa please? Like that. I'm trying to contact Donna. Saya berusaha menghubungi Donna. Hi Desi Merah. I'm calling on behalf of. Okay. Ini adalah kayak misalkan kalau sekretaris atau personal assistant, mereka biasanya kan nelpon, tapi yang nyuruh tuh bosnya gitu. Tolong telepon ini dong gitu. Kayak misal if you guys watch The Devil's Wears Prada. So, yeah. Hi, hi Fatul. When The Devil's Wears Prada, the main actress job was the personal assistant of Miranda, right? So, she used this term. I'm calling on behalf of Miranda. Can I get to Patrick? Yeah, something. May I speak to Dolce Gabbana? Something like that. Jadi, if a personal assistant use this, yeah. Dewi speaking, how may I help you? This is the way we speak. Okay, may I ask who's calling, please? Yeah. Could I speak to someone who is in charge yang bertugas gitu? I would like to make a reservation, please. Nah, kalau ini biasanya di apa nih? Biasanya di restoran ya, or hotel ya. Kalau misalkan lagi pesan sesuatu, booking sesuatu, I would like to make a reservation, please. Ini yang formal. Could you hold on a moment, please? Ini yang formal. I'm sorry, he's out of the office today. I'm afraid my English isn't very strong. Could you speak slowly, please? Nah, jadi kalau kita kan kadang gitu ya, my English is not very good ya. Tapi kalau di sini tuh, I'm afraid my English isn't very strong. Ini sama aja. Could you please speak slowly? Ya, gitu. Can I leave a message, please? Thank you for calling. Ya, this is the formal way. And this is the informal way. Hi, is Darius here? Hi, is there, is Donas there? I'm in the post office at the moment and I just needed some apa gitu ya. Hello, Mera's phone. Who is it? Just a minute. Jadi kalau dalam formal, kalau dalam kantor ya, itu kita nggak boleh nih pakai istilah-istilah ini nih yang ada di sini. Just a minute itu nggak boleh. Could you please hold on? Ya harus pakai itu. Oke, okay, wait a moment please. Ini juga masih informal maksudnya. Mera is out of the moment. Mera is out at the moment. Nah, itu enggak. Jadi dia pakainya yang ini. Ya, yeah, I'm sorry. He's out of, harus pakai sorry ya. Sorry, I didn't catch that. Nah, ini catch-nya yang informal. I can hear you very well. Ya, yeah, ini enggak boleh ya. Can you, could you please repeat? Nah, itu kayak gitu tuh bolehnya tuh. I'll ask him to ring you when you are back. Ya, yeah? When he is back. Ini maksudnya suruh telepon balik kayak gitu. Ini informal. Ini yang kalau kita sama temen. Nah, kalau ini yang kalau di kantor. I'll let Uswa know that you rang. Aku akan ngasih tahu Uswa kalau kamu telepon kayak gitu ya. Bye. We don't say bye on the call. Talk soon. Speak to you again soon. Ya, yeah, this is the informal way. Okay, thank you for calling ya biasanya ini. Okay, any questions about this? Ada yang kalian nggak ngerti nggak istilahnya? Dona, Uswa, Desi Merah, ada yang nggak
Ada
ngerti?
ke tempat tuh? Ada ke tempat tuh?
Which one,
Ada.
Fatul?
Bukan aku
Which
yang
one?
Fatul apa yang gak ngerti? Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning,
Good
Fatul.
morning.
How are you,
Good
Fatul?
morning.
Hey,
Fatul, how are you? I'm fine.
How are you? I'm fine, thank you.
Good morning.
Good morning. Okay.
Good morning.
So, try this one.
Good morning.
Fatul, you're gonna try this one, okay? This is answering the phone. When you answer the phone, introducing yourself, asking for someone or something, connecting someone, asking the person who is being called for the phone call. Ini adalah yang digunakan ketika menjawab telepon. Kata-katanya tuh kayak gini, ya. Yeah. Oke, okay. Desi Merah, coba this one. Try the first one. Desi Merah, try to read this one. Good morning.
Yes.
Okay, try.
Good morning. Good morning.
England. PC.
PC.
This is
England PC.
Yes.
This
good.
Is Sarah speaking. This is Sarah speaking.
Okay. How can I help you?
Help you? Pilih salah
yeah.
satu kan?
Pilih salah satu, betul betul betul.
How
can I help you? Good job.
How can I help you?
Okay, good job Merah ya. Jadi gitu ya kalau kita ngangkat telepon tuh kayak gitu. Good morning, England PC Services. This is Sarah speaking. This is Desi Merawati speaking. How can I help you? Ini diganti ya, namanya diganti nama sendiri ya. Okay, next Donat. You try this one, Don.
Oh, jadi bisnisnya diganti sama kita sendiri gitu ya,
iya,
misalnya.
Betul, nama-namanya
This is
nih. Kalau Sarah ya diganti.
Oke.
Kalau Kevin diganti Dona ya. And then try to
Yeah,
introduce
done. Look,
yourself.
you're done.
This is Luna.
You nggak apa-apa, from-nya pakai yang ini nggak apa-apa. Don't you have to mention your full name?
Even your apa?
Your full name.
Full, oh. Full name. Hello. This is Dona Junita from Kunciran Technology Firm.
Good job. Good job, Don. Okay, Uswa. This one.
Can I speak to Dewi? Please.
Thank you. Good job. Yeah. Yes, you may. Okay, I'm gonna call him first. Like something like that. Let me get Dewi on the call first. Okay, good job. Now, Desi Merah, this is you again. Your part.
Yes, yes. Bentar, bentar. 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 Sebentar, yes, yes. Aduh, gak kelihatan.
Can you do it, ma'am? Udah donat dulu, donat. Kasihan banget sih ibu-ibu, mama. Sabar ya, mama. Semangat belajar. Donat, donat dulu, donat.
Wah, dekat sini, sini, sini. Sini aja duduk. Sini dulu.
Ini juga lagi, ini tuh nge-babysitter.
Sebentar, yang mana? Ya.
Nih, this one. Oh, merah udah bisa, om belum. This one, don.
Yang mana? Which
connecting
one, deh?
Someone. Connecting someone.
Oh, connecting someone. Just a moment, please. I see if he is or if Mr. Ade is available.
I just become Mr. Bayu. Good job, Don. Good job. Uswatan, this is yours.
Okay. Mrs. Devi, I have got a Mrs. Donna on the line for your from Friend Technology Firm. Will you take the call?
Iya, jadi dia tuh nanya dulu gitu ke yang itunya. Ini ada telepon nih dari ini, mau diangkat nggak gitu ya? Good job, Uswa. Thank you. Mer, can you speak now? Mer masih bertarung sama Fatu. Donna, your part again. Ini sebenarnya tuh kayak nyambung.
Tulisannya kepotong sebentar layarnya nih nggak tahu nih sebentar ya.
Bisa. And then, so baru kau semangat semangat. Don. Don, are you here? Ah, Dona. Ketutup. Uswa
Yes.
ini to ini. Oh, Dona ada.
Okay.
Uswa, can you read this one?
Yes. Yes. Please put him talk. I'm not available right now.
Ah, good job. Kayaknya ini true ya seharusnya ya. Put him
Oh,
through.
true.
Kan put through kan tadi kan phrasal
Yes.
verb-nya ya. Yes, please
Yes,
put
please.
him through. Itu nih contoh kalimatnya. Yes, please put him through. I'm
I'm not
not
available.
available right now. Kalau put him through tuh bukannya biasanya nyambungin. Itu seharusnya nyambungin gitu. Put through, see? Connect to another person. I'm available right now. Maybe it's supposed to be like this. I'm just putting you through, Mr. Stephen. Huh? Nah, ini dia. Jadi katanya, thank you for holding. I'm just putting you through to Mr. Stephen. Ya. Yeah? Okay. Nah, ini kalau misalkan dia. Ini apa? Ya, kayaknya dia kepencet apa gitu ya. Thank you for calling Mr. Jeff. Goodbye. Okay, let me repeat that just to make sure. Jadi kalau misalkan kita mau confirm sesuatu tuh kayak gini. Okay, problem. Kalau misalkan dia ngomong tapi nggak kedengeran ya, nggak jelas. Sorry, I didn't quite catch that. Could you say your name again, please? Yes. Sudah si Merawati. Handphonenya berebutan sama Fatul. Yes, it is Kevin Jeff here. Could you ask him to call me when he is available? Nah, ini kalau mau taking a message. I am sorry, Mr. Steven is out or busy now. Can I ask who's calling? Would you like to leave a message? Is there anyone else you would like to speak to? Okay. Kalau explaining absence, I'm sorry, he's in a meeting at the moment. Ya, yeah. Ya yeah, itu kayak gitu. Ini sebenarnya sih
dan cara. Sudah kembali IG. Sudah kembali.
Ini loh, ini hasil patul nih, itu hasil patul ceret-ceretannya. Ini sama ya. Oke.
Okay. Oke, okay, sudah kembali aku ya.
Pick, 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 pick. Mera, you have to pick a box ya. Kalau nih, ini jadi kalau misalkan kita jawab telepon tuh kayak gini, hello, Judy speaking, how may I help you? Introducing yourself tadi udah ya sama semuanya. Yang ini nih, Mera yang belum. Coba yang ini, Mer. Leaving a message with someone.
Talking a message for someone. Yes. Talking a message for someone.
Leaving.
I'm sorry. Leaving. I'm sorry.
Mana sih I'm sorry? Oh ini ya. Taking
leaving.
A message for
mana sih dia?
Yang ini. Oke.
Okay. I'm sorry. Ini diganti saya sendiri apa gimana tuh?
Iya boleh.
I'm sorry, Lisa. Oh, I'm sorry, Lisa is out. Or busy at the moment.
Can I ask who is calling?
Can I ask what is calling?
Who is calling?
Can I take a message?
Uh-huh.
Call. Can I take a message?
Uh-huh.
Nih.
Ya betul.
I. Nggak dinaikin. I will. I will. apa tuh? No.
I will let him know you called. Ya, yeah, kayak gitu.
No, you called. Yes.
Yeah. Good job ya, Fatul ya. Good job. Jadi ini ya, kalau misalnya kita mau living
Fatul, ya.
On an answering machine, juga ngomongnya kayak gini, hello, this is Tom calling for Jenny, could you please return my call as soon as possible? My number is 688-899. Thank you, kayak gitu. Ini kalau apa namanya ada telepon di apa ada mesin penjawab telepon yang otomatis ya kalau di luar negeri ya. Jadi dia biasanya meninggalkan pesan dengan menyantumkan nomor handphone, nomor telepon baliknya gitu. Jadi orang yang denger akan tahu, oh oke okay, gitu. Nanti dia harus telepon balik ke sini kayak gitu. Ini dia, I need to hang up now. I'll talk to you soon. Bye. Ya, kayak gitu. Ini most of the telephone language. Ini adalah istilah-istilah ketika kalian bertelepon dalam bahasa Inggris ya. Oke. Okay. Ini kalau kita dalam bahasa Indonesia atau pakai fonetik. Nah, ini yang spelling number. Nah, kalau bahasa Inggris ya, kita kan akan menyebutkan angkanya ya, 273-3748, kayak gitu. Nah, kalau 0 itu, kalau British menyebutnya 0, kalau Amerika menyebutnya 0, ya. Jadi kayak gini, 505, nah itu berarti pakai British tuh, 1025, kayak gitu. Atau 505-1025, kayak gitu. Tapi sekarang rata-rata sih udah pakai 0 kalau menyebutin angka ya. Oke,
okay?
Sekarang okay, coba okay. Sebutin nomor handphone kak, nomor jangan nama-nama. Ini aja. Kalian baca ini dengan menggunakan huruf, oke? Okay? Try ya. Oh, I got my phone number right. Wait. I not told. Let me write down my phone number. Oke, okay. 08. Oke, Now, Uswa, can you please read this but with letters? Jadi dibaca hurufnya ya, kayak gini ya, kayak di
okay.
Asia. Okay? Go ahead.
Okay. O H 17 O O 136 19.
Okay, good job, Uswa. Donna, your turn. You can use 02 if you want.
08170000136619.
Yes, good job. Itulah Uswa ya. Kalau kamu bolos jadinya begitu. Enggak tahu.
Padahal tadi baca
ketiga.
Iya benar tadi baca nih. Kata double nomor angka. Oke, sip.
Dia kalau itu suka baca double atau triple ya, kalau ada yang angka 3 sama okay. Gitu dia pasti ngebacanya triple. Kayak gitu, triple eight kayak gini nih, triple eight, double six ya kan?
Okay.
Double six, triple eight kayak gitu. Isi merah your turn, can you speak up?
Yes.
Ayo Fatul. Can you read this number, Fatul?
Yeah.
Umi, Ate Nur.
Zero. Itu ya deh yang ini. Zero eight one seven double zero one three six one nine.
Yes, good job. Ya Allah, Umi Fatul.
Jadi kalau nol di awal bisa, oh bisa zero nggak apa-apa.
Bisa nggak apa-apa, Cuma kalau kalian udah pakai zero harus zero terus ke belakang. Nanti orangnya bingung kalian di depan pakai zero, di tengah pakai o gitu kan orang pasti bingung. Nah kalau pakai zero ya zero semua. Kalau pakai o semua.
O semua. Okay,
eight
okay.
Ya. O 817001369. Zero
orang matematika tuh zero. Orang matematika tuh zero, jarang O.
Oh, ini matematik. Beda kalau guru matematik. Ini bisa dilawan. Okay, good job. I need to erase this. Okay. Nah, ending the call. Nah, kalau ending the call itu kayak gini. Thanks for calling. Bye for now. I have to let you go now. I have another call coming through. I better run. Kayak gitu. I'm afraid that's my other line. Kan kalau kita lagi teleponan, terus ada tutut gitu ya. Maksudnya ada orang lain yang nelpon kita kayak gitu. Kita akan ngomong sama dia. Saya rasa itu ada telepon masuk yang lain. Kayak gitu. I'm afraid that's my other line. I'll talk to you again soon. Bye. Kayak gitu. Okay, I'll phone back after lunch. I'll call you back after lunch. Kayak gitu. Okay, I need to erase this. Okay. It's been great talking with you. Thank you. Good morning. Kayak gitu. Kita pasti ini yang formalnya kayak gini. Thanks for calling Unggul Jaya Corporation. Good morning. Kayak gitu. Dan ingat ya, selalu ingat good night itu adalah bukan sapaan, tapi good night adalah perpisahan kayak gitu. Jadi goodbye itu cuman good night itu cuman boleh kalau berpisah, enggak untuk greetings. Kalau greetings pasti pakainya good evening. Oke. Okay? Itu ilmu dasarnya sih. Okay.
Good apa deh? Good evening.
Good night. Jadi kalau kita kan selalu selamat malam kan pas datang gitu ya. Halo, gitu kan ya, selamat malam. Nah, itu bisa gitu ya. Tapi kalau di bahasa Inggris itu nggak bisa. Hello, good night. Nah, itu nggak bisa. Kalau good night itu cuma
berkata.
Pasti dia kalau mau dada-dada baru good night, see you, bye, kayak gitu. Nah, tapi kalau halo, selamat datang, itu dia pakainya good evening. Mau selarut malam apapun, mau jam 11 malam itu tetap good evening kita nyebutnya. Hello,
hi.
Ini sama ini aku salah.
Oh.
Selama ini aku nggak tahu.
Ngomong aja.
Iya, maksudnya kan karena kita kan selamat malam itu ya, ketika kita ketemu sama orang, ya sama selamat malam ketika kita berpisah juga ya bye gitu ya. Tapi kalau dia tuh good night itu nggak bisa dipakai buat menyapa orang. Good night itu cuma boleh untuk mengucapkan selamat, maksudnya ketika perpisahan gitu. Kayak gitu. Oke, nah ini common etiknya ya. Jadi kalau dalam telepon, when you make the call, when you do some telephone call, people cannot see your face, right? So it's very important to put smile in your voice. Because when you smile, that energy will be received by the recipient, yeah? The recipient can feel that you're happy. So you have to put smile in your face, okay? That's a very basic thing for everyone on the call, yeah? Kalau kita apa? Pasti kalau kita nggak senyum atau kita lagi bad mood, itu pasti kedengeran deh dari suaranya deh, dari penerima telepon itu sangat sensitif. Auranya itu akan sampai. So you have to put smile in your face when you make a phone call, okay? Okay, the next one is personalize your reply. It means you have to mention their names. It's very appropriate, yeah? Kan rude, yeah? It's very rude when you talk to someone, but that someone only mention you like, okay, sir, okay, ma'am, okay, but it doesn't, they didn't even say your name, like, thank you, Miss Dewi. It's better than thank you, ma'am. Yeah, if ma'am can go to anyone, kayak gitu. Jadi kita, you will feel special and feel recognized if that other person is mentioning your name. So you have to mention the other person name. Kayak, thank you, Uswa, ya. Daripada thank you, Bu. Kayak gitu kan, itu lebih ini gitu ya. Lebih personal, lebih sopan, lebih enak, dan lebih menyenangkan kalau dipanggil namanya, disebut namanya ya. Personalize your reply. Jadi harus mention namanya si orang yang di telepon itu. Misalkan ada yang telepon kita, kita harus sebut namanya beberapa kali dalam sepanjang telepon itu. Malah kalau di dunia kerja, sebenarnya itu ada aturan ketika kita teleponan sama orang, kita harus sebut namanya itu minimal 3 kali ketika kita bertelepon itu. Let's try for example like this. Okay, hello, hi, good morning. Yes, good morning. With whom am I speaking? Oh, I'm Uswa. Okay, hi Miss Uswa, what can I do for you? Yes, can I talk to Miss Dewi? Okay, wait a minute Miss Uswa, I'll try to talk to Miss Dewi first. Okay, terus udah ngomong nih manggil Miss Dewi. Oh, hello Miss Uswa, I'm sorry, Miss Dewi is still in a meeting. Can you please call her back in 15 minutes? Like that. Jadi kita harus bolak-balik itu, berulang kali itu resepsionis itu sebut namanya. Kalau dalam bertelepon dalam bahasa Inggris kayak gitu, itu akan lebih spesial ya. And speak clearly, jangan muter-muter kalau di telepon ya, harus ngomong yang jelas. And cheerful the color smooth, jadi harus bantu mencairkan suasana, jangan terlalu kaku sama orang itunya juga gitu ya, harus dibantu bersemangat gitu, bukan semangat. Nah, ini ketika making a call, jadi yang pertama itu step-nya, introducing yourself, memperkenalkan diri dulu, hello, my name is Uswa, ya. Terus intention-nya, sebutin tujuannya, I need to book a reservation, atau I need to talk to Miss Dewi, atau I need to talk to Desi Merawati, gitu. Atau kayak gini, is Donna is in the house, kayak gitu. Itu dia nanya, ya, ada apa. Maksudnya sebutin tujuan dia nelpon itu apa. Terus ini reason for calling-nya juga sama, kayak intention purpose of calling itu sama. Asking to be connected tuh, minta tolong disambungkan ke siapa. Kalau misalkan seseorang itu nggak available, ya dia pilih gitu ya, ya nanya gitu ya, dia kemana atau gimana gitu. Informasi yang dia baliknya kapan, kayak gitu, itu bisa. Sama ending conversation, jadi itu step-stepnya. Ada pertanyaan?
No.
Why no?
Enough.
Enough ya. Oh, kita yang ini aja ya. I'm gonna have a conversation. I'm gonna make a phone call. We have many role play. Kemarin tuh Dona role play-nya sama Miss Rara mulu. Maaf ya Dona, sekarang kan kamu punya teman nih, ada Uswa, ada
langsung lancar ya.
Oh. Gantian. Main mau mulu.
Pinter ya Don. Dan udah pinter Don.
Baca pinter doang. Pinter baca doang.
Itu kan alam bawah sadar, secara alam bawah sadar Dona tuh dia sebenarnya tambah jago loh, Don.
Jangan-jangan dia sambil naik motor itu dia. Dengerinnya.
Iya. Ya kali naik motor.
Okay. Nah ini dia, yeah, this is the basic one. This is Miss Rara's slide. Okay. Okay. Nah ini dia yang kalau kita tersenyum itu pasti kelihatan keberasa bedanya ya, sama yang kalau lagi marah-marah ya kayak gitu. Desi Merah sama Uswah ya sekarang ya gilirannya role play. Dona udah puas Don?
Dona belum puas, bosan. Yeah. Bosan
role play Don, jangan bosan ya.
Nggak ada yang lain apa sih? Mau nggak mau
karena sertifikasinya biasanya untuk ini ya, untuk administratif perkantoran, makanya ini diajarin yang formalnya semua. Jadi kalau formalnya tuh kayak gini, harus menjawab telepon itu langsung. Batasnya tuh cuma 2-3 kali berdering tuh udah selesai. Okay, let's recap this for a while ya. Kita recap ini dulu sebentar, nanti baru habis itu role play Donas Merah sama Uswa. This is the do's and don'ts when involving telephoning. Okay, so answer the telephone promptly, preferably within second or third ring. Ya, jadi di sini maksimal telepon tuh 3 kali berdering harus langsung diangkat. Ini aturan yang tidak tertulis ya. Greet the caller and identify yourself. Hello, this is. Okay, gini. Misalkan kita kan greet-nya itu hello gitu ya. Hello, good morning. Terus misalkan identify ourselves-nya, Dewi speaking. Terus nah, dia pasti nanya tuh ya kan ini bagian apa segala macam kita bisa kasih tahu. Perhatiin speed-nya, volume-nya, nice happy tone itu bisa dibantu dengan tersenyum. Ask the caller's identity, tanyain, hello, who is this? May I help you? Like that. Hello, with whom am I speaking? Kayak gitu. If you have to, nah ini yang hold, tadi kan phrasal verb-nya udah dikasih tahu semua ya, istilah-istilahnya apa gitu, yang cara ngomongnya tuh gimana kalau kita mesti bikin mereka dia hold on ya kan. Terus kalau ini listen actively, speak clearly and politely ya. Mereka tuh jujur agak sensitif banget gitu sama sopan santun kayak gitu. Itu kadang kalau kita ngomong sambil makan, sambil itu enggak ya, enggak boleh. Jadi itu harus ini banget. Harus benar-benar supaya mulutnya itu clear gitu ya ketika kita berbicara, dan harus sopan. Gunakan bahasa yang baik ya, dan ini sering-sering panggil nama orang yang itu sama ya kayak yang tadi dijelasin, dan always keep a pen and paper ya. Jadi kalau dia nul nitip pesan atau apa, itu resepsionis biasanya pegang pulpen dan kertas. Kayak gitu. Nah, ini jangan jangan diburu-buru. Ayo, can you please speed up gitu ya. Oh, kita lagi teleponan gitu. Can you please speak faster kayak gitu. Aduh, I'm in a hurry kayak gitu tuh enggak boleh ya. Terus jangan pakai bahasa-bahasa slang ataupun language. Jangan makan sambil minum. Jangan makan atau minum sambil teleponan. Dan jangan misalkan kita lagi teleponan terus itu kan gak enak gitu ya. Don't talk to the others while you're on the phone. Nah, ini dia. Don't rely on memory ya. Jadi kalau misalkan penulisnya apa, penelponnya tuh ngomong apa, kita harus tulis. That we have to write down. Okay, this is more for the office ya, yeah, for the office people. Don't say he hasn't come yet or he's on the toilet kayak gitu nih. He's not available. Kita nyebutnya he's not available. Nggak boleh marah-marahin orang yang ditelepon. Nggak boleh manggil first name. Jadi sebenarnya kalau kita kan biasa gitu ya, manggil uswah, ya first name-nya uswah kita panggil gitu. Tapi kalau dalam bahasa Inggris sebenarnya biasanya dia tuh panggilnya tuh nama last name-nya orang British or foreigners gitu ya. Mereka biasa panggil last name-nya atau keluarganya. Jadi nama keluarganya, jadi bukan first name-nya yang ketika menyapa orang. Nah, ini jangan didiemin sampai berapa detik ya, atau sampai lama gitu ya, nanti keburu lupa gitu kita ngangkat teleponnya tuh, jangan. Ya kayak gitu. Okay, any question? Okay, dan this is the conversation. Okay. Nah, ya. Ini tadi udah ya cara-caranya. Now this one, Desi Merawati and Uswa.
Ya. Yeah.
Yes, Uswa.
Lagi makan dulu. Apa?
Mau ini dialog Uswa and Desi Merawati.
Oke. Oke.
Uswa, are you available? Connection. Ini ya, seperti yang tadi di telepon phrases itu ya. Ini apa namanya, kalimat-kalimatnya untuk memperkenalkan diri. Ini untuk menyampaikan tujuan telepon kayak gitu. Terus ya, intention to call itu maksudnya mau ngomong sama siapa kayak gitu. Nah, reason for calling ini tujuannya itu apa, kayak gitu. I'm calling about, I'm calling to, kayak gitu. Ini-iniannya. Nanti ini kalian akan terbiasa sendiri ya. Tapi yang penting tuh di ini aja, dibaca aja. Nanti akan terbiasa sendiri, oke? Okay? Uswa, can you do the dialogue with Desi Mera?
Yes, I can.
Okay, good. Who will be Michelle and who will be Mike?
Okay.
Yes.
Michelle. Uswa Mike ya.
Okay.
Kita ganti nama Uswa ya. Yes.
Yes, you can switch the name.
Mulai ya.
Sure. Go ahead.
Hello. You have reached the marketing department. How can I help?
Yes, can I speak to Desi Mera, please?
Who calling, please? Who is calling, please?
Is Uswa here?
Certainly. Please hold and I put your you talk.
True.
Thank nice you.
True. Lanjut deh.
Thank you.
Okay.
Hello. Hello, marketing. How can I help?
Could I speak to Desi Mera, please?
Certainly.
Who shall I say is calling?
My name is Uswatun Alawiyah.
Just a second. I will see if he's in. Hello, Uswa. Iya deh, salah. Hal.
Yeah. Itu Desi Merah. Jadi ceritanya hello Desi Merah. I got Uswatun Alawiyah on the phone for you.
Hello Desi Merah, I have got Uswatun Adawi on the phone for you. Okay, I will put him through. Hang on a moment, I'm just putting you through.
Gitu. True.
Oh, okay. True. True.
I'm just putting you through.
I just putting you through.
I need to write something on here. Wait, give me a second. Good job, Desi Merah. Good job, Uswa. Thank you. Okay. So this is two different words, yeah?
True.
Yeah. Ini dough. This one is dough.
Dough.
Uh-huh. And this one is true.
True.
Dia bacanya sama kayak true yang ini nih. True. I will put you true. How do you write this? Okay. True. Hampir mirip. This one.
Oh, true.
Ya, tapi true. Different meaning. Ini beda arti.
The meaning?
Tapi dia mirip cara bacanya.
Benar.
True. Kalau yang ini true. Kebenaran. Kalau yang benar. Ini true. Ini TH ini Tawai. Sebenarnya ada apa namanya? Ada triknya cara mengucapkan kata-kata dengan TH. Jadi kalau kita biasa nyebutnya TH word. Kalau di guru-guru bahasa Inggris gitu kita nyebutnya TH word. Kalau di natives, kalau di orang-orang ekspatriatnya, orang British or American ya, mereka udah naturally ini kalau TH ini tuh jadi lidahnya tuh kayak agak-agak digigit sedikit gitu loh. Kayak gitu. Jadi kalau semua kata-kata yang ada TH-nya termasuk ada three. Nah, kayak gini. Ya. Ini harus beda sama three. Nah. Ini kan enggak ada H-nya ya.
Three.
Jadi kalau yang ini itu itu lidahnya kayak gitu dulu. Three. Nah, kalau yang ini three. Lidahnya enggak digigit. Three. Ya, kalau yang ini three. Jadi lidahnya kayak digigit dulu. Emang gitu. Ini kita nyebutnya TH word, tapi percayalah bukan cuman kalian yang mengalami kesulitan ini. Semua orang yang bukan
ngapain pakai digigit-gigit sih tuh lidahnya three.
Emang begitu. Kalau TH word itu
kayak belajar ngaji juga. Hurufnya.
Ya udah abis ini kita belajar ngaji. Three.
All the words.
Belajar ngaji like kan hurufnya beda-beda.
There.
Okay. Terus apa lagi?
These.
Semua TH word itu lidahnya harus keluar dulu. Dia pasti meskipun kedengarannya kayak do gitu ya. Kalau D kan, kalau ini kan do, kalau D itu kan di dalam ya sebenarnya. Nah, tapi ini karena dia TH word, jadi sebenarnya do-nya dia itu lidahnya digigit dulu.
Do.
Baru masuk gitu. though. Gitu. Terus ini through.
Three.
Kayak gitu. Jadi through. Mulainya itu lidahnya dari kayak huruf fa ya. Jadi ngaji ya, kayak huruf fa ya. Kalau huruf fa kan gitu.
Abis ini kita liko, abis ini kita liko. Liko abis ini kita masukkan grup liko.
Ya, jadi kalau yang ini bacanya
panggil kakur dia. True.
Kalau yang ini bacanya do. Tapi do. Lidahnya tetap dari depan huruf do.
Do.
I cannot go do kayak gitu.
Sungguhnya abis ini juga lupa lagi nih deh.
Enggak lah, nanti kalian pasti besok-besok kalau baca sesuatu yang ada TH-nya kalian akan ingat. Oh iya ya, kemarin tuh si Ade tuh ngajarin tuh TH tuh lidahnya dikeluarin dulu, digigit dulu kayak gitu. Iya. Paling paling simpel ini aja deh. Tree sama tree. Kalau tree itu ya udah tree itu pohon. Kalau tree tiga.
Tree.
Iya.
Tree.
Ya, jadi harus dibedain ya, tree sama tree. Yeah. Oke? Okay? Bisa, good job.
Okay.
Kalian terbaik lah, pokoknya kalian terbaik ya. Udah good job ya.
Tree.
Bangga sama diri.
Enggak, tenang. Ini apa namanya? Emang ini kok emang
proses ya, proses.
Belajarnya tuh lama, TH word, TH word.
Karena lidahnya udah 40 tahun, Uswa. Lidah 40 tahun beda, Uswa. Jangan berharap cepet-cepet dapat.
Otak 40 tahun ya.
Iya, jangan berharap cepet-cepet kita. Kita ya udah nikmatin aja.
Menulis di atas air ceritanya ini. Gak apa-apa. Ya,
kita udah menulis.
Kita kan ada, minta sama
kita
Allah.
Kita bukan menulis di atas air lagi nih.
Dibukakan ini ya, apa namanya, kemampuannya gitu.
Tabir.
Lidahnya.
Dengan tabir tuh biar langsung bisa.
Iya, Pak. Jangan dikakukan. Oh. Lidahnya itu maksudnya dilenturkan. Jadi kita bisa mengucapkan bahasa Inggris ini dengan fluent ya. Oke, okay, semangat, cayo ya.
Oke. Semangat. Okay.
Next, this one, Barbara and Michelle. Okay. Dawn, are you sure you don't want to read again?
No, I have done yesterday.
Dona udah bosan. Hanya Uswa and Desi.
Dona udah bosan, Don. Ya Allah, Uswa. Okay. Ya udah saya sendiri dah, Uswa.
Okay, Uswa, MS Barbara, okay, Des.
Kamu gantian ya.
Yeah.
Okay, kamu ahead. Barbara.
M first ya.
Oke.
Okay. M Jok Barbara.
Uswa. Ya.
Oke. Okay. Hello. This is the press office.
I would like to speak to Rachel Als. To Rachel Als, please. Yeah.
I'm sorry. You must have the wrong number. There is no one of that.
There's
no one here.
Hey. Oh, can I check the number I've got? Is that not 55 55 69 790?
68.
Hey, 68 790.
No.
Bertanya, soalnya bertanya harus ya. Berarti jero gitu ya harusnya.
No, it's 555-8790.
Oh, sorry about that. I must have dialed the wrong number.
No problem. Bye.
Good job.
Bye.
Kan bedanya ya, kalau merah ya tuh kalau orang ikut pelatihannya dari awal pasti udah lebih jago kayak Uswa. Merah kan baru berapa kali masuk, baru 2 kali kan, jadi wajar. Nggak apa-apa ya Mer,
nggak apa-apa, biasa aja.
Pokoknya harus semakin rajin itu akan semakin berprestasi. Itu sangat menentukan.
Iya. Baik, keluar dari Morina kita langsung cis-cis deh. Enggak pakai bahasa Indonesia lagi.
Iya.
Iya, betul. Amin. Oke, ini ya one word, this one is dialed. Bacanya dialed ya.
Dialed. I must have dialed.
Jadi dia asal katanya dial, and then tambahin ed, dialed jadinya.
Dialed. I must have dialed the wrong number.
Okay. So the first form was, sorry. The first form is dial, and then
dial.
Tapi ini dibacanya dialed. Okay?
Dial.
Jadi bentuk pertamanya dial. Itu dial. Okay. Dial itu mencet nomor telepon, itu namanya dial. Redial berarti mencet nomor telepon ulang. Nah, dialed itu bentuk lampaunya dia, bentuk past tense-nya dia. Jadi dialed gitu. Bisa ya? Good job.
Insyaallah.
Next. This one, Dawn, are you sure you don't want to read this again? I'm asking you again.
No. kalau enggak yang ini enggak apa-apa, tapi yang satu lagi ntar, ini dah. Kasih mereka berdua yang panjang.
Iya. This one, you with me, and then after this, Desi Merah and Uswa again. Because the other one is longer, right?
Okay.
So will whom you will you be, Jane or Ruth?
Jane deh, nggak apa-apa.
Okay, go ahead, Jane.
Hello, press office. Can I help you?
Don, you're answering a phone call. You have to be like more.
Oh, yeah.
Come on.
Hello. Donna speaking, press office, can I help you?
Hello, Dewi is here. Dewi has to see, please.
I'm sorry, you've got the wrong number, but he does work here. I tried to put you through.
Ketika, when I mention Dewi, you have to switch he to she. She.
Oh, he. But she does work here. I'll try and put you through. Okay. In future, his direct number is 555-8770.
Double seven zero.
Did I not dial that?
Do you rang 555-8790?
Oh, sorry to have troubled you.
No problem. Hang on a moment and I'll put you through to Paul. To Ade Extension.
Okay, good. Thanks. Thanks. Okay, good job everyone. Good job Donna. Good job me. And now Uswa and Mera, your turn. Ini aku karyanya. Okay. Okay, silakan Desi Mera and Uswa. Go ahead. Who's going to be Michelle and who's going to be Peter?
Yes.
Ayo Uswa, kita mulai.
Desi, apa? Michelle or Peter?
Michelle, nggak apa-apa. Michelle ya.
Oke.
Hebron's office. Desi speaking. How may I help you?
Hello. Hello, nggak usah pakai perkenalan ya, Bun.
Enggak, sedikit.
Oh, hello, can I?
Baca aja.
Okay. Dia baca aja. Hello, can I speak to? Hello, can I speak to Donna, please?
I am afraid he's in a meeting until lunchtime. Can I take a message?
Well, I would like to arrange an appointment to see him, please. Is Uswa here?
Could you hold on for a minute, Mr. Jefferson?
Ini ngikutin aja deh.
I just look in the diary. Tunggu ya, pause terus. So when's confinance for you? Confinance ya? For you?
Sometime next week. Sometime next week if possible. I gather his oil the following week.
Yes, that's right. He's on holiday for a fortnight. 14 night.
Well, I need to see him before he goes away. So, would next Wednesday be okay?
Wednesday, let me see. He's out of the office all morning, but he's free in the afternoon. After about
3 o'clock is difficult, but I could make it after 4.
So, shall we sail 5 past ini? 4:15 tuh? 4:15. 4:15 next Wednesday. In Mr. Hibbert's office?
Yes, that sounds fine. Thanks very much.
Okay then, bye.
Good job, Desi. Good job, Buswa. Okay, I have a few notes for all of you. Okay, this one. Okay, so this one, there's two different words. Here we have massage. Okay, massage itu artinya pijat, urut ya, massage. And this one is message. Message artinya pesan. Jadi ini dua kata yang berbeda, meskipun mirip ya, mirip. Tulisannya soalnya mirip.
Message.
Ini cuma beda satu huruf doang sih, ma sama me. Ini massage, massage itu pijat. Kalau message itu pesan, ya. Jadi jangan sampai ketuker. Can I take a message? Kayak gitu. Jangan can I take a massage. Kalau can I take a massage, jadi aku boleh pijit nggak gitu, oke?
Okay? Pijat.
Oh, oke. Okay. Massage and message, oke? Okay?
Okay.
And the next one is Wednesday. Jadi ada nih yang kayak gini sama Wednesday. Kayak model vegetables. Vegetables itu adalah salah cara bacanya, bukan vegetables tapi vegetables.
Vegetable. Gimana, Mas?
Gak dibaca ini A-nya tuh gak dibaca, gak kayak table gitu ya. Kan ada kata table gitu ya. Kalau table kan dibaca ya A-nya ya, table gitu ya. Kalau dia enggak, jadi vegetables. Vegetables.
Vegetables,
ya. Yeah. Terus kalau ini Wednesday. Jadi ininya enggak dibaca, tengahnya tuh enggak dibaca.
Wednesday.
Aha. Ya, tengahnya dia tuh enggak dibaca. Okay, draw.
Wednesday.
Nih, bagian tengahnya dia tuh enggak dibaca. Wednesday. Nah, terus nih dia ininya nggak dibaca, vegetables kayak gitu.
Vegetables.
Ya. Jadi tengah-tengahnya nggak dibaca, dia modelnya sama tuh kata-katanya. Jadi Wednesday. Ini emang nggak Wednesday, nggak ininya nggak dibaca tengahnya. Nah, ini juga nih vegetables, tengahnya nggak dibaca. Oke? Okay? Ada lagi?
Oke, okay. Wednesday. Wednesday.
Wednesday. Langsung
gitu
ya
bro.
Wednesday gitu bacanya.
Vegetable.
Kenapa Don kamu raise your hand?
Rustle apa deh?
Apa?
Rustle
tuh buru-buru. Misalkan aku lari buru-buru ngambil pulpen sama kertas, nah itu rustle.
Maksudnya dia tadi tunggu sebentar dia ngambil apa gitu ya?
Iya betul. Sebentar ya, aku mau ngeliat di buku, di catatan gitu, di agendanya si Mr. Jefferson kan. Jadi dia pause, terus dia rustle, maksudnya dia buru-buru gitu, buru-buru tuh ngambil si buku agendanya kayak gitu. So when's convenient for you? Terus baru dia nanya jadwal lagi kayak gitu. Itu rustle.
Rustle. Baca ya, jam dong Bun.
Kenapa?
Itu jam 4 lewat 15, misalnya jam 4 lewat 30. Oh,
dulu ngajarin orang, tapi ini lupa deh. Ngajarin anak. Pas.
Sebenarnya, kalau jam kayak gini ya, itu ada bacaan resminya tuh kayak gini. Bacaan resminya kan, kalau 4.15 itu berarti a quarter past four. Bacaan resmi ya kan, yang aku tulis. A quarter past four. Jadi 15 menit lewat jam 4 gitulah, jam 4 lewat 15 menit, quarter past four. Tapi kan kita kan ini ya maunya simple ya. Jadi aku mau baca aja langsung 4:15 gitu. Jadi ini kan ada titik, itu pembatasnya. Kalau untuk jam itu nggak apa-apa, biasa kok orang native juga kayak gitu. 4:15, 4:30 kayak gitu. Tapi ini jangan digabung sama ini, maksudnya ini dipisah, jamnya terpisah sama ininya terpisah menitnya gitu. Jadi yang 15 bukan 415 ya, bukan 415 juga nggak boleh kayak gitu. Tapi kalau jam itu dia biasa nyebutnya kan dia pasti cuma 1 2 3 4 sampai 12 karena kan di sana pakai ampm ya. Nah, terus 15-nya ini jadi 1 nggak apa-apa, 15 30 atau 5, misalkan 405. Oh, kalau begini dia pasti bacanya 405 nih. 4.05. Ini nolnya harus dibaca. Kalau di menit. 405. Ini harus dibaca. Kalau mau dibaca yang sesuai ketentuan ini, 5 past 4. Kayak gitu. Jadi dibaca ininya dulu, menitnya dulu, baru jamnya. Sebenarnya ada juga aturan agak ribetnya yang menjelaskan kalau dia mendekati ke jam setelahnya, kan misalkan gini, 4:45. Kita tulis di mana lagi ya, di sini ya. 4:45. Kalau 4:45 ini kan lebih dekat ke jam 5 ya. Kalau orang sebenarnya ada aturan ininya yang garis gitu ya, aturan resminya yang menyarankan dia itu bacanya ke jam 3. Jadi a quarter 5 kurang 15 kan. Jadi a quarter to 5. Jadi dia maunya bacanya a quarter
to 5.
Kayak gini. Kalau jam itu ada ininya begini aturannya. Jadi kalau dia lebih deket ke jam setelahnya, berarti kita harus nyebut jam setelahnya. A quarter to five. Kalau 4:30 itu boleh nyebut ke 4 atau boleh nyebut ke 5 gitu. Tapi kalau misalkan 4:35, nah itu berarti udah ini. Disuruhnya ya aturan sebenarnya ya. 4:35 ini aturan sebenarnya adalah harusnya kita bacanya 25 minutes 25 minutes to 5. Cuman kalau menurut aku tuh ribet ya kayak gini ya. Jadi kalau saya sih pasti bacanya 4:35, 4:05, 4:45 kayak gitu. Gak apa-apa kalau dalam bahasa Inggris juga biasa pakai gitu kok, foreigner. Kita kan belajar supaya kita kayak ekspatriat ya, supaya kita kayak bule ya. Jadi gak apa-apa. Jadi kita baca aja kayak bule. Bule-bule juga bacanya kayak gitu kok ya. The foreigner also read this like that. 4:45, 4:35. When is a good time for you? Is 3 a good time for you? No. Let's make it 4. 4:15, 4:40, 4:45. Kayak gitu. It's okay. Yeah. Okay. Any more questions? Yes. I'm gonna read the whole one.
Karena no.
Kenapa?
No.
No apa?
No question.
Oh, no questions. No. I thought you were saying no, so I don't have to erase this. Okay. Let me read, yeah. I'm gonna try to read this whole. And please notice about the word, how the word is said. Please notice the pronunciation, okay? This is offering for reschedule. Michelle. Hibbert's office. Michelle speaking. How may I help you? Peter. Hello, can I speak to Brian Hibbert, please? I'm afraid he's in a meeting until lunchtime. Can I take a message? Well, I'd like to arrange an appointment to see him, please. Is Peter Jefferson here? Kalau ada yang nggak jelas, tanya nggak apa-apa ya. Could you hold on for a minute, Mr. Jefferson? I'll just look in the diary. Pause, Russell. So when is convenient for you? Sometime next week, if possible. I gather he's away the following week. Ini tuh gather di sini, gather itu sebenarnya artinya gathering, perkumpulan. Tapi kalau di sini tuh maksudnya kayaknya dia tuh pergi deh naik minggu depan kayak gitu. Ini kayaknya deh, kira-kira deh. Saya kira-kira dia tuh pergi deh kayaknya deh gitu. Jadi gather bisa berarti bukan gathering juga ya. Yes, that's right. He's on holiday for a fortnight. Fortnight itu maksudnya ini gitu. Apa namanya? Liburan fortnight. Well, I need to see him before he goes away. So, would next Wednesday be okay? Wednesday, let me see. He's out of the office all morning. But he's free in the afternoon after about 3. 3 o'clock is difficult. But I could make it after 4. So, shall we say 4:15 next Wednesday in Mr. Hibbert's office? Yes, that sounds nice. That sounds fine. Thank you very much. Okay then, bye. Okay, that's... What do you think? Okay?
Okay.
Okay. Wow, it's almost 9:30. Oh my God. Okay, conclusion. So we need to pull
out. Time is 9.
Clear, yeah, when in the telephone call. And there's a different language expression used in telephone, both for formal and informal situation. Use it properly. Okay. Oh, then. Thank you.
Yep.
Thank you. Mrs. Ade Dewi has to teach.
Kenapa usah?
Miss Dewi, can yes. you say screen phrasal verb tadi?
Oh, phrasal verbs. Okay.
Phrasal verb.
Phrasal verb. This one.
I want to screen.
I can send you the document.
Mr. Ade, Mrs. Ade.
9:30.
Iya sayang, iya. Iya sayang, iya. Press the verb.
Oke. Yang tadi kilo-kilo tuh, Bun.
Which one?
Sila, yang apa? Abjad, abjad ya.
Oh, abjad. Buat
spelling. Itu kan? Buat spelling itu kan?
This one.
Yes. Sip. Oke. Okay. Thank you.
Oke. Okay. Dah. Udah selesai okay. Nih kita nih pelajaran kita hari ini ya. Thank you ya semuanya udah hadir. I love you all.
Love you too. Okay.
And now we're gonna close the app, everyone.